This year, the World Poker Tour is celebrating our 10th anniversary with the Seminole Hard Rock in Hollywood, Florida. We've had multiple events per year there for a decade now, which means loads of records set and really special memories made for countless people.
You know, I have great memories of this place. Yes, Mike Sexton and I saw the great local Michael the Grinder Mizrachi play. He finished second in the Tournament of Champions and also third back-to-back years. Very impressive.
Over the last 10 years, I've had so many great memories at the Seminole Hard Rock and made some lifelong friendships with Director of Poker Operations William Mason and the General Manager of Poker, Mr. Larry Frank. With their leadership, they have brought poker tournaments in South Florida from non-existent to an industry leader, setting records on the World Poker Tour.
For me personally, the Seminole Hard Rock will always hold a special place in my heart because it was the location for my very first moment on set with the World Poker Tour. So it was August of 2013, and we were filming our $100,000 buy-in high roller series, WPT Alpha 8. It was the first event for WPT Alpha 8. It was the first episode we'd ever made of that show, and literally my very first episode as WPT anchor. So this was my first time to work on a big American production, even. This Aussie had just moved to the United States, so I was just so overwhelmed with all of the emotions. And it was my first trip with WPT, and I remember checking into the Hard Rock and feeling like an absolute rock star with all of the memorabilia around to just make it all feel extra cool. And just being so nervous in my hotel room going over my lines and wondering, should I say World Poker Tour with more of an American accent? Because I say it kind of weird. Is anyone going to understand me? So many of these things are running through my head. And then I remember entering Hard Rock Live and walking the halls of an actual arena, like to get to where our TV studio had been built. And it was just, it was mind blowing. So I'll just never forget that feeling, and it all started right there.
Back in season 13, I actually played the tournament. I finished 27th out of hundreds of players. I picked up 22,000, so that's my lucky place.
My fondest memory at the Seminole Hard Rock has to be from the first season there in the final table in which I was announcing, when a very young Taylor Von Kriegenberg took down the poker legend Kurt Kohlberg for over $1.1 million.
Another special memory from Seminole Hard Rock was the World Poker Tour's very first Tournament of Champions. So this is now our flagship season-ending event where the winner is quite literally the champion of champions. And it was Mike Sexton's vision to create that. And I remember always hearing him speak of this idea and how we needed to introduce it to the WPT. And when it finally happened in 2016, it was there at the Seminole Hard Rock. And I was blown away by how beautiful the room looked. I knew that this was a big event, but as soon as you walked in, you just knew like, oh, this event is special. And it is. And it was there at Seminole Hard Rock that really set the bar for what it still is today. And seeing the pride on Mike's face at that first event as he walked around that room so elated that his TOC vision was finally happening was just beautiful.
Met our newest champion, Ilya Mirazi, on day 1B. It was sometime around the dinner break of day 1B. I was outside hanging with a few friends and catching up with them, and Ilya came up to me and said, "Hey Tony, I watch you and Vince and the show all the time with my son. We're huge fans. Is it cool if I just hang out for a little bit and ask you some questions?" I said, "Yeah, of course, man. You can free kick it. What's going on?" And he said, "Well, you know, I've never played a WPT before. I've never played a big live tournament before. I satellited my way into this. Do you have any advice for me?" And I was like, "Whoa, that's a very broad question in the spectrum of poker strategy." And I did my best to talk to him about bubble dynamics, what his priorities were in the tournament, how he should be mindful of the payout ladder, should he go deep. And we just kind of kicked it and shot the breeze for a little bit, and he was on his way. And I really didn't think anything of it until the final day of the tournament. I get a message from one of my friends who was out there with him, and he's like, "Yo, that guy we met, Ilya, he's like chip leader in this thing." And I look at the final table and I couldn't believe it. I mean, he just seemed so excited just to be there. The fact that he played himself to the final table was incredible. He ends up winning the event, becoming our newest WPT champion. and has this incredible backstory, and having met him that day just felt like one of those surreal, serendipitous moments that can happen in the world of gambling and poker sometimes. So I've had so many good memories and played so many awesome events at the Seminole Hard Rock, and I'm going back down there in a couple of weeks. I can't wait for more, and I'm sure there's plenty of great memories to come.
I want to congratulate Bill Mason, Larry Frank, and the entire Seminole Hard Rock team. I look forward to another 10 years of great memories and many more record-setting fields.